Ladies, gentlemen, boys, and girls, welcome to another episode of the 4Play Podcast. My name is Brandon Rosa. With me to my right is
Mike.
Over there in the Jenkinson's Pavilion, a boardwalk t-shirt. One of my favorite things ever is still that I never visited you, but picturing you working a boardwalk ride is a beautiful image in my head.
I went and saw him once.
Did you? Yeah. What was he doing?
He was working the laser maze.
The dream.
And he was trying to.
It doesn't exist anymore, by the way.
I was about to say, it's not there anymore.
In order
when
to
Sandy
try,
hit it.
In order to try and draw people in, you know, he'd get out on the boardwalk and stuff.
I didn't dance. I had a mic, right?
Yeah.
And I was, you know, attached to speakers. And I would just be like, come play the laser maze. Like, oh, what's awesome. Up?
What is laser maze?
It was this, you picture James Bond when they're like, the villain is like trying to go over the lasers to steal the diamond. Yeah. That it was like those types
of
lasers.
You gotta try to fit yourself over and through these.
I remember that.
It was there for a year or 2 years and Sandy wiped it out. It was really unfortunate how it worked out because it was a fun game.
Did anybody try to do like double barrel rolls over?
Oh, people did all sorts of stuff it was a video and camera inside too, so you got to see
that's
the people.
Cool.
People on the outside could watch.
It was fun. I enjoyed it. It was fun.
I just love the pauses on the show. Mike goes, what was that? Picture James Bond. Pause. By the way, this is Kevin.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Kevin.
Fucking gay.
He's gay. So, on the 4Play Podcast, each day of the week a new video goes live. On Mondays, a little tease for the topics. Tuesday, a talk time topic. Wednesday, a would you rather question to debate. And Thursday, do you know, should you know question. All culminating in the full episode on Friday, where the video episode will go live at youtube.com/4playvideo. And the audio podcast will go out to iTunes and Google Play Music. Michael is not Brandon. Teasing the topics. I will tease the topics, but Michael has brought us a treat. I was excited.
What the hell?
Let me
was
live
that?
A little bit.
I didn't even see his face though.
No, I didn't. I'm glad I didn't.
So, Mike, what do we have here?
Almost a broken bottle.
No, that's not good. Oh,
wow.
You should have done that right in front of the mic. So Michael has brewed his own beer.
Yeah.
And we're going to try it. Mike, how do you brew a beer?
Throw some...
Oh, that is gorgeous. Very hoppy.
Nice.
You throw some yeast and grain in a toilet. And then you close it and let it sit for 2 weeks.
To ferment, like, one might say.
Yeah. No, there's a lot of steps and like... Halfway through doing it, I was kind of like, because the kit that I had was 1 gallon. You only get like 10 bottles of beer out of it. So like through the whole process and shit, I was like, this kind of isn't fucking worth it.
It was a lot
but
of
at the same time, it was pretty nice because it does get you to appreciate like how beer is made and stuff.
Yeah. So it's something you're going to do again.
Yeah, I kind of want to. But I want to try like.
Well, isn't this like a hobby that starts to get crazy where you can get like really like not like you personally crazy, but like really great like equipment and shit like that?
If I like actually had a clean garage, I'd want to do like the 5 gallon, which so you can get like 50 beers. So that's worth it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Because it's pretty much the same effort.
So you
for the 1 gallon versus the 5 gallon.
Yeah.
Some may say fermentation is the single greatest invention in this world.
I heard that.
Bread, beer, cheese.
You don't need any more, honestly. Now, Mike, I'm going to warn you. So what does this taste like to you? Is this like an IPA stuff?
It doesn't look like it.
It's
because I don't like them, so I don't want to offend you
exactly,
if I don't like them.
I tell Mike as well beforehand.
It's not super hoppy.
It's just beer.
Kevin, like the man over here. Cheers, 4Play.
I know.
Looks like fucking champagne.
It's pretty good.
Okay.
I like it.
That'll put some hair on the chest. No, this is actually really good.
Mm-hmm.
It's
not like super strong.
It's one of those ones that I'd rather have with like a meal. You know what I mean?
Mike, I'm not just saying this because we're on a show and because I've known you all my life, but this is exceptional.
This is really
now, let me explain. I don't like IPAs, but this is just hoppy enough.
That's what I was
saying. So it's not... Because I don't like IPAs because the hops
too
just kill it and
yeah.
I can't do it. This is good.
This is good, buddy.
Thanks.
I'm going to need more of this, however. So you're going to have to start working on
you better,
this.
He needs
better
five
get
to work.
Yeah, clear the garage
ingredients, perfect. The same exact way again.
Well,
oh,
the
tough
part
factor.
Would be
yeah.
to once you mass produce, or the bigger thing is scaling everything, right?
Well, yeah. Well, that's the weird part, because like doing something in the process at a different temperature could have like completely changed the taste of this. You know what I mean? Like there's a lot, there's so many different factors that.
Yeah, that's what
many
sucks.
Nuances.
Yeah. Did you like write down what you did?
Well, you just like Rose's notebook?
No, it comes with.
Yeah, this was really good.
With like the recipe thing, but I can go back on the website and get more grain and shit, and then you can get different flavored hops and stuff like that.
I liked it a lot.
Yeah, this was really good, buddy.
Enjoyed.
Thank you, sir.
I'm not a beer guy.
No.
I like this.
So, it's my turn. For the topics.
Now, makes no sense, because there's nothing.
There's there. No one that hates it more than my girlfriend, though. Friend of the show, Nicole. So.
Has a few guest appearances.
Yes, one. So, no one in the thing of transparency. Sometimes we know each other's topics. Sometimes we don't. Nobody knows what these topics are today at the table.
Nope.
Now, I've been saying for a while I wanted to do this topic because I wanted to revisit a conversation that we had in high school. So all I'm going to say is the tease for that topic, and maybe you guys will grasp it again. For Fairly talk time is grenade, period.
Oh my gosh, I know where this is going. 100%.
I'm excited.
I've got it.
Kevin, do you remember? Mike might not know this. I don't think Mike was a part
of
this conversation. So I'm going to blow his mind.
Oh, I do.
Yep. Yeah. See? Oh,
damn,
isn't that good?
Let's go.
If it's the term that I think you're talking
about,
that was
so funny.
Then
No, but honestly, I don't think you like were in this conversation.
All right. Let's do it.
We'll do it when we get the song time.
Chris is very frustrated.
Chris.
Yeah.
Chris.
So
probably the angriest out of everyone with this topic.
Ready? For Would You Rather, we're going to debate some guns and some melee weapons. And for Do You Know, Should You Know, I'm going to be the instructor in the firing squad.
The what?
The what?
We're going to get very America and gun talk on this episode of the 4Play Podcast. Yes. When we return, we will explain this grenade tease in the talk time topic of the week.
Oh my gosh. Let's do it.
Oh, I was excited. Fuck am I excited, because we're going to revisit a topic.
An age-old debate.
An age-old topic that Mike doesn't know. So, Mike, I'm going to tell you a little story. I'm going to take you for a little walk here.
I'm going to take everyone for a little walk.
So, at some point in high school, our friend Nick, over here, I want to say I did. I don't know if I posed the question, but the topic came up. Nick tried to convince all of us. So, all right, I'm example, right? I have a grenade in my hand. The trigger is the pin is pulled, right? There is a 0% chance I am going to survive if I'm holding this grenade. Is that correct?
What?
Nick tried to fucking tell me, Mike, that there is a chance with him holding a grenade in his fucking hand that he would survive.
There isn't
that
to,
it, like,
be,
if,
to be more
if
clear.
There's like any chance possible.
There's like infinitesimal.
No, I'm telling you, there's 0%
chance. He's saying absolute zero. I'm saying infinitesimally 0.00000001.
Miracles.
Thank you, Michael.
The thing
Thank
was,
you, Michael.
But it's no joke, like bullshit. Like, this was a misfire. The grenade.
Yeah, I know. He probably
fired.
Wasn't even thinking
I know
that.
The grenade fired, doing exactly as it was designed to do. Blow the fuck up. There is
Well, I mean, the only, because I'm not an expert on grenades. The only thing that I have to say is, like, there's plenty of people that step on landmines and they only lose a leg. They don't die.
But here, let me tell you this. So, all right. So, topic, for the sake of everyone who doesn't know, is can you survive? Any feasible way or chance for you to survive by a grenade detonating in your hand while holding it? So, Mike, yeah, you're saying the landmine. That's on your feet. That's away from all your vital organs. No matter how far your hand is, it's near your face, near your fucking half your body, because our arms aren't that long. You're blowing up some vital organs. You're not surviving.
The only reason I'm saying...
Watch a grenade explosion real quick. Just to get some...
So Kevin just pulled up a video. Is he holding the grenade?
I think so. He hasn't pulled anything.
Wait, here, let me hold it so Mike could actually see it as well. So if you just YouTube grenade explosion real quick.
Oh, he threw it.
He's going to throw it over. Now let's watch this thing explode.
All right.
I guess where's the fucking nade piece?
Getting older.
Oh, frag out. That. That.
An explosion.
That is like a mini nuke.
It's an explosion.
I mean, the only reason I'm saying it's possible to survive is because how many fucking crazy shit have you heard about in your lifetime of just ridiculous things of people surviving?
Thank you.
Like, just the famous one of the dude, like, back in the day, like, a fucking pole fell off a building or some shit.
Impaled.
And it was, like, a pole this thick that went through his fucking head. And he survived.
Anything's possible.
There was also that woman, my other argument. Woman a few years ago that literally got straight up shot in the dome and survived.
That's my straight up argument is that there is a possibility. That is all.
Oh, even if it's that only 1%, yeah.
Even
yeah.
if it's only 0.01%.
No. No, there is not. If a grenade,
I say we do an on-show test.
Well, no, we can't.
Only
do
one
that.
Who survives is the winner.
The grenade explodes. You can't get your arm more than what 3 feet right, away from your body.
All right, fine. Let's put out the idea. You step on the landmine, right? What's stopping me from holding the grenade and like kneeing on it? Now my legs are in the way. At least there's something extra in the way.
That's not the debate. The debate is you're standing, you're holding the grenade. And okay. you're fucking just
keep,
it's
keep
out,
the same.
It's in your hand.
Area, yeah.
You cannot
survive. Conclusively say that it was a 0% chance.
Where? How are you going to survive? There's shrapnel in a grenade.
Of course,
it's just going to blow your body in half. Yes. You're not going to survive.
99 out of 100 times probably won't. 99 million out of 100 million times, or actually, that's incorrect. 99 million and one times. I probably still wouldn't survive. Absolutely.
Hey.
But I'm arguing that the 0.00000 whatever, 1% chance exists. That's all.
Jason Pierre-Paul survived.
A firework.
Again, it's not even about if we have a physical proof. Like, you know, maybe one day someone will hold a grenade and it'll go off and they'll survive. And then we won't even need to have this argument anymore. I'm just arguing that the possibility exists. That's all.
Kevin, please tell him he's wrong.
I'd like to believe that there's
the chance.
Zero chance.
Thank you. I thought you were about to turn sides because I distinctly remember that Nick was fucking alone in this fight.
I was
there's
alone
a lot
in
of
this
different
fight.
Factors,
I was entirely
too. I mean, what are you wearing? Are you wearing a juggernaut suit?
No, you're wearing street clothes.
A bomb deflecting yeah. suit in the middle
yeah,
of the day.
There's no...
You are in a field. You're in what you're
the
fucking
one
wearing.
A fucking grenade. Yeah, I mean,
in a field.
No, it's normal circumstances. Like you're in normal street clothes. You're you.
Normal circumstances holding a grenade.
Yeah, aside from that point, yes.
I don't know how we approached that subject.
Yeah, I don't
but
know where that came from.
I don't know
the
where
fact
it came from.
Is you are definitively not going to survive with a clear cut explosion from a grenade in your hand. It is a fucking bomb designed to kill.
Of course, so are landmines. Thank you, as Mike said earlier. Yeah.
There's like fucking propulsion. A landmine's under the ground.
Oh, yeah.
You step on it, it fucking shoots you away and
like
blows your legs off.
It's not like it's 6 feet underground.
Yeah, it's right under the sand. It's right there.
Yeah, but you're on it.
Nothing.
It's just going to blow your legs away. This grenade is
yeah, it's just going to blow
in your
my,
hands.
It's going to blow half my chest away.
No, it's going to blow you away. Where all your vital organs are. All it makes is like a
yeah,
piece
yeah.
of shrapnel in your heart. You're done.
Of course. But then also people could survive shrapnel through the brain. Maybe shrapnel through the heart. Nothing's stopping me.
Regardless of whether or not you survive this explosion, you're going to be in no condition
oh,
to want to do anything.
You're going to have a miserable life whether you survive or not.
There's
absolutely.
No life.
I'm just arguing that the possibility exists that you can, in fact,
the meaning
survive.
Of life is to survive.
That's all.
I don't think we said that on last week's show.
Additionally.
It used to be.
Yeah, now we don't survive anymore.
In fact, we could even extend the argument because I don't believe in a 0% chance of anything. I believe that there's always any infinitesimal chance that anything wacky
no.
could
oh,
happen.
Yeah. This is where I started to get really mad. Now I remember, you said that there was a chance at everything. Nick, if you
there's
get blown into space, there's no fucking chance of you surviving.
It's very low chance. Highly unlikely.
No, you say this because a troll. You can't
there's
actually
no troll.
Believe this.
There's no troll. I 100% believe that there's always a chance for anything.
You said
there is a 0% chance.
Yeah. Low job in space. You're not
that surviving. You will never not order a cheesy gordita crunch from Taco Bell ever again.
Wait, there's say that once more.
There's a 0% chance that the next time you go to Taco Bell, you will not order a cheesy gordita crunch.
Fact.
Then I can literally go to Taco Bell and not order that.
I'm saying.
Oh, he's
that's what I'm saying. You can't use that percentage anyways. And it still, again, it wouldn't be 0%. It would be 0.00. No, I misinterpreted it.
No, I was straight up.
I know.
No, I was saying that there's 0% chance.
Yeah, because he knows that I get cheesy gordita crunch every time. That's what I get every
Nick,
time.
Nick, there's not a chance that if you go into space... I'm playing with the mic this episode. If I blow you the fuck into space, you are not going to survive. That is definitive. There's no oxygen, which is vital for the human to survive.
There's 0.001
space.
Whatever percent. 10 to the negative 1 million percent chance. It's basically non-existent.
He creates a breathing apparatus
out of kelp
with his clothing.
It's basically
as he freezes in the sub-zero temperatures of space.
It's basically
not even that. Your body contorts impossible. Into nothing. You just implode.
Again, majority of the time, absolutely. But there's that fluke, one in one Google
Nick,
of
your,
a chance.
Your logic doesn't. So you're saying there's a chance that if you don't eat or drink for 2 years, there's a chance to survive.
That chance exists.
You're so stupid. I can't.
How is it stupid to consider all possibilities?
Mike, can you get behind us now a little bit and join our team, please? The grenade. You're so stupid, but whatever. But this mother. Are you on his team now? You gonna be on team Nick? Huh?
See, here's the thing. All I would need to prove any of this argument wrong is to have one of those things actually happen. Then there's conclusive evidence that it was in fact a 0.1% chance and not a 0% chance. You know what I'm saying?
No.
For instance, if you're saying there's a 0% chance someone holding a grenade dies,
yes.
15 years from now, someone holds a grenade and survives, who's right? I'm correct because I said there was at least a 0.000 whatever percent chance. It was extremely unlikely.
Unlikely.
Unlikely, but it happened. And therefore, I was not wrong for having that low possibility. It's highly unlikely. In fact, we may never see that in our lifetime.
Because it's
you could run it in a simulation a trillion times and it can fail a trillion times. That doesn't mean that the next trillion, there won't be one that succeeds. The next quadrillion, there won't be one that
now,
succeeds.
Now, is it a German old school grenade with the stick on the end so it's further away from you?
No, we could say an omnidirectional exploding shrapnel grenade.
So there's a chance if I drop a 500x500 square foot anvil on you, there's a chance you could survive.
Yes, absolutely. There's always a chance.
I've given up.
Where are you finding one of those?
Outro talk time. I'm done.
how can you conclusively say that there is a 0% chance of anything? he's out. He's walking out the door. He's out. This argument got everyone just as angry in high school, and nothing's
fantastic.
Changed.
I love when he reaches that point, though. it's phenomenal.
I would have hoped that the years have changed everyone to see the line of reason that nothing is impossible. Only a Sith. I wish Brandon was here because only a Sith deals in absolutes. That's all I have to say. So when Brandon records, when Brandon looks at this later, he'll be able to realize that he is in fact a Sith.
All right. Well,
so
we'll be back shortly with the Would You Rather for the week. Hope you enjoyed that.
Thank you.
Time for the Would You Rather question. As I return to the podcast, because Nick frustrated me so hard, I had to leave.
So frustrated.
But maybe we'll calm down
Triggered.
A little bit. Trigger, yeah. So I want to know, if you had the ability, would you rather be extremely sick, awesome, nasty at firing guns or wielding a melee weapon?
So, samurai.
So we're going to keep with the weapons. This is going to be the weapons podcast.
Where do bow and arrow fall into that? That is a
That's
significant
a good idea.
Question.
Ranged.
But the bow and arrow is so stupid and inefficient.
No, honestly, I might pick the bow and arrow. That might have to be a third We might have our first.
If I ever got gone hunting, that's what I would want to do. I wouldn't want to hunt with a rifle.
Yeah. So that. All right. So we're gonna do the first ever third choice. So it's would you rather be skilled
firing a bullet at an animal?
You're shooting an arrow into its heart.
What did you say?
Well, again, if you're the best at either, you'd have the ability.
No, I'm just talking in general right now.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's a lot harder to hunt an animal by bow than
absolutely. Yeah.
Well, yeah. There's
more room for error.
Way more room for error. Even if you're the best, there's still room for error.
Yeah, so that's the conversation. Would you rather be skilled at bow and arrow, guns, or melee weapons? Immediately, swords. The bow and arrow is crucial because if there's a game, like a video game with bow and arrows, like fucking Tomb Raider, all I do is shoot the bow and arrow. We played Battleborn Beta. I was Thorn with the bow and arrow. Legolas. Loved him.
As much as I would love to be skilled with a fucking katana.
See, that would be
There's no room for it in this world, and I just have to go with guns because if you're most the best practical with it, then fucking join the Navy SEALs. I don't know.
Yeah, but see, that's the thing because that's the smartest choice, well, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
But it's just like, you ever see a motherfucker wield a blade? Who could wield a blade? That shit is cool. That's the coolest option.
You just had an accent for a second.
I was channeling. Being sick with a blade is cool. Being sick with a bow, I mean, I think that's badass. I think
that's cool, too, yeah.
What about like a staff? Like
a bow staff?
Like just hit somebody with a stick.
But it's like, ability. What are you going to do?
Like Donatello.
I could be a ninja.
Yeah, something like that.
Here's the deal. Here's the deal with what you just said. You're skilled with the weapon. You don't necessarily. You said you could be a ninja.
Yeah.
You don't gain any more athleticism with your skills with a sword.
Big but nimble. Friends, gamer
hashtag. Yeah.
Bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Well, the thing for me is, I have no practicality to be good at any of these.
Before you say that, I would just like to say, although to defend myself, I'm a big boy. I am quiet. What? I could be very sneaky, like a slurry snake.
Do you judge that on like how quiet you like reheat like pizza in like 2 o'clock in the morning?
Yes,
or something?
I was the best as a kid sneaking.
So that makes you just.
I'm the best. I'm quiet. You never hear me coming.
Pee down on the side of the bowl to make sure. You're not...
perfect angle, right at the side, so you don't get. Continue, Nick.
Audio representation. No, but I don't really have an advantage to learning any of them aside from the coolness factor. Because, like, I don't hunt. I don't believe in violence or anything like that against any life form. So, really, it would just be to look cool.
What if they touch your nipples?
I still wouldn't, like, kill someone for touching my nipples. I mean, don't get me wrong.
What if they held you down for hours?
Well, then I have no idea what I would do at that point. I'd probably lose my mind.
Imagine what just went through his head.
His fucking brain would just break.
Having somebody just go like this.
I guess for the sake of practicality, likely either guns or bow and arrow, because at least there's an Olympic event for both of those. I could at least turn that into something profitable.
Just imagine being like the best sniper who's ever lived.
Yeah, but I wouldn't be able to, as I said, that wouldn't
He's
help.
Saying he couldn't pull the trigger.
Like, I wouldn't be in the military because I wouldn't be able to kill people with that. You know what I mean? Like, sure, I'd be the best sniper, but it wouldn't matter because I wouldn't want to kill anyone.
But it'd be still so cool.
It would be cool. Yeah, absolutely. That's all, like, though. It would just be cool.
What about hand-to-hand combat?
That's part of the melee weapon. It's a melee weapon.
Yeah, well, you could do that. You could choke people out.
What's crazy about being, like what you just said about being the
top sniper,
the
elite.
Best sniper.
What's
like,
his name?
Kyle.
Movie? Yeah.
Like, all I think of is like, okay, you're on the battlefield and you shoot some guy that's like miles away. All
right,
and
I'm
you start
done.
Yelling at all your dudes. You're like, dude, I just got that guy all the way over there. You're like, no, you fucking did.
Yeah, no.
What are you talking about? There's no videotape of you sniping the hell out of him.
Now, what if there was a video of you?
Well, I mean, you do have a scout next to you, though.
Oh, so big boy scout.
Oh, shit. He did it.
You were just talking. You were literally deflecting bullets right there. That's what you were doing.
Well, I was. See, I might pick.
Yeah, that's what you were doing.
No, I might pick melee because if I could be a Jedi, then, I mean, Jedi or die.
Yeah, but you'd be a Sith.
That was a lightsaber.
Yeah, you were deflecting bullets right there.
Well, because, you know, with the sword, Jedi lightsaber.
In a world in which we harness the power of plasma and we create lightsabers.
Caliber crystals.
Hot magma.
Hot magma. So I think we're all a little... I got to go with the bow just because anytime there's a game, I just love firing a bow.
You love space.
This is real life.
Well, fuck it. I'm going to be the bow hunter.
Yeah, I'd have to go with bows or guns simply because there's at least a profitable market.
You're saying
for
bows
that.
Or guns are two different options. All right, here.
Fine, then I'm going to
choose. Or hand to hand combat,
which is in melee.
I'm going to choose
my fist.
Guns.
Guns.
More practical. God forbid it ever has to come to something like that where I need to use a gun
to defend yourself.
Well, yeah,
defend
you could myself. Just go into sport.
Yeah, I would just go into the Olympics. If I'm the best one, then I'll get the gold and make some money off that. Okay. So.
Mr. Michael, where you at?
Which I honestly don't think is even that much.
It's probably not that much, but it's something. At least I'm turning one of the skills into something more than nothing.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to pick melee going into this, honestly.
Mike or me?
Mike.
Yeah. Like that Nabushi pointy stick. For honor.
Stick with a kitchen knife on
the because that way. Is the thing about melee is it's fucking so versatile. I'm saying you could be skilled with a knife, a bow staff, nunchucks. We didn't even talk about nunchucks.
Who cares about fucking nunchucks?
My daddy has a pair of nunchucks.
What? I don't. So I'm what? Uncomfortable that you said daddy,
Papa.
Not dad or father.
Papa.
Or something.
Ninja stars.
That too.
Throwing knives.
Those are throwables.
Yeah.
Different.
It's not melee anymore.
Ooh. It's
well,
you're using your yeah. So your skills are melee because it's hands. So I'm like, where you at? Where you going? Where you at?
What you doing?
Mike's a little.
I'd want to go melee, but I think I'd have to go sniper.
Sniper, that'd be really cool. Remember when you had that airsoft sniper?
Yeah, sold it was, for like dirt cheap.
That thing was so cool. Oh, Nick.
I'm actually thinking about getting a
paintball.
Paintball sniper?
CO2 BB gun.
God.
Liquid hot magma. Yeah.
Go out and shoot some squirrels. Oh my God.
But can't have it in New Jersey, so.
Yeah. All legal. Kevin, where you at? Where you going?
And no, I'm not going to go out shooting squirrels. Fucking...
You hunt beaver. Stop getting all them dams.
You go out and hunt the beast that's out in your yard right
that
now.
Needs to be killed. I'm sorry about animal cruelty, but there's a beast that scares us all in this fucking...
Wait, what actually is it?
We don't know.
It's a giant groundhog. But
I,
dude,
think
this thing,
I think it's a skunk.
No, I've seen it. It's
fucking stuff bubblegum in all the fucking holes. If it eats the bubblegum, the shit expands in its stomach and it explodes.
Pick me up, buttercup, baby. Don't you let me down.
It sounds terrible. If it's even true, it sounds inhumane
it's
anyway.
Terrifying his family.
It is. It's terrorizing us.
You're losing sleep at night. You're laying in bed like, what am I going to do?
It's out there.
Fucking tremors.
It's hunting.
Tremor. God, that was classic.
Kevin Bacon.
I don't know what I want to do with this.
I thought you would have went guns. I didn't know where Nick was. I thought Mike was going to go melee. I thought you would have picked guns. There's no real rhyme or reason for any of my reasoning, but just what I thought.
Just like anything else.
My mind is whispering.
Cult classic.
I don't know.
Thanks.
I mean, cult classic. Like they were saying, I mean, the guns are just, it's like practical use. It's
that's
arranged.
That's the smart choice. Bow is the badass choice. Cool is the
so
melee
I could,
choice.
I could be proficient with guns, become a police officer.
Never.
If I ever find myself in one of those
hostage situations,
you would be wasting situation. Your time as a police officer.
Hostage situation.
If you were the hitman, Agent 47.
Everyone would be like, why are you here? You're just like, you know, just protect and serve. You got to do.
Then they just instantly cut him to behind a desk. I don't know. That's what I pictured.
Then he does his first desk.
Yeah.
9 o'clock. Let's have a great day, everyone.
Cult classic.
So I'm alone. You're all gunsmen.
You do a bow?
That scene is so funny.
How inefficient.
Legolas.
The bow.
Legolas.
He thinks he's
Legolas.
The fucking arrow.
Dude, I love bows. I don't know why. There's no real reason. I just do. I would like to do archery when I'm older.
Have you ever fired a bow and arrow?
Into the ground. No, I was trying to learn. Our friend Brent, his brother, has a bow and arrow. And one day in the backyard,
right.
I was trying to... Wasn't very good. He's practicing.
It's not easy.
Change my answer.
There's a steep learning curve.
Fucking blow dart gun.
I think that's a gun. It's literally has gun in the name. Well, let us know which you would choose on this three option would you rather question for the week. Every Wednesday, a new would you rather question goes live at youtube.com/foreplayvideo. We'll be back with Do You Know, Should You Know from me in a moment.
Sure. Thank you.
So I had a question during Would You Rather that I saved because I didn't want to spoil my Do You Know, Should You Know topic for the week.
Questions.
Yes. Oh, were you just saying the word question? Yeah. So just throwing off every cadence I've ever had in my life at youtube.com/foreplayvideo for Foreplay the podcast. Do you know how to fire a gun? Because I don't know if any of you have fired guns before.
Nope.
Call of Duty.
My psychologist
says no. He says no. Nicholas?
No, I've never fired a gun, but I did go to a police camp where I held a real gun. I don't know what that means.
That
but
means nothing.
I once held a gun.
It was a real gun.
I once held a piece of metal in my head.
But I obviously did not fire it, so no, I've never fired an armed firearm.
Kevin?
No. I fired a paintball gun once.
Yeah, I fired a paintball gun.
So no one's ever fired a real gun at this table?
I shoot blanks every day.
That's an immature joke.
No, I've held a gun before, but yeah, never shot one.
We need to all go shooting.
Yeah,
because I have fired guns now 3 times in 2 states.
Great.
I don't like the idea of you having a gun at all.
I'm gonna have a gun. I was going to apply for my license recently, but
for what?
To have a gun.
Why?
To get a gun.
For what reason?
Yeah, I think more than ever, the proof in this world, it explains more than enough right now.
Yeah, I
would
have a gun in the house as well.
With the world going to shit. I would like to be, I don't want to use it, I'd like to be just be able to defend myself if need be.
Honestly, beforehand, I was only afraid of you around children, but definitely afraid of you around guns as well. So
we're all going to go shooting soon. It's very, I can see why people like, it's like almost therapeutic. I mean, it's actually fucking terrifying like the first time you go because you're thinking about it. You're in the fucking shooting range. There's people next to you and wow, he could fucking
turn.
That's
Gonzo.
It.
Gonzo, Alonzo, yeah. Kiko.
I wanted to bring it up because I didn't think you guys had, but I wanted to know if you guys think it's important. I think it's fun. It's very, the first time doing it is quite scary because it's like, you literally just like, the hardest part of learning to shoot a gun is like you're apprehensive because you're pulling the trigger.
Yeah. And there's the kickback as well, I'm sure.
Yeah, well, on a handgun, you're not really going to get that much.
The one thing that's like weird is like, obviously guns are very serious, but like I feel like I used to like hold them up like very high. You know what I mean? Like until recently when you realize it's just a fucking like little mechanical.
You mean like it's this? You used to think it's out
metal.
Of this world. Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I mean. Like, it's.
I know
just
you're
a tool.
Yeah. Yeah. But you know it. I mean? But it's the scariest tool in the world because
know,
it's final.
I know, but yeah. I'm saying like, once you realize it, that it's just. Once you just like take it out of the element that guns, what guns are mostly used for, and you just think of it as like a sport. Where like anything like BB guns or anything like that or paintballs,
you boil it down to its simplest.
Yeah, you're just shooting a piece of metal. You know what I mean?
It's just, yeah, it's fucking scary.
I feel
though.
Like I'd be scared the first time I go. I feel like it'd take me like, I would eventually do it. It would take me like a second though to actually be able to.
No, it does because it's like the scariest thing is you fire that and you're shooting it at a target, but it's like wow.
Yeah.
If someone was there, that's how you end a life.
Yeah.
Like, everyone could do it with their hands, whatever. You pick up a kitchen knife, you could do it. You can fucking kill anyone with anything, anyway. But a gun is like, it's
specifically
designed
that.
To kill.
Yes.
There's not much other stuff in this world that we're going to touch that's designed to kill somebody. Mm-hmm. And we're all able to just, we can go right now.
Yep.
Go shoot. And that's a fucking scary thing.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that'd definitely be a hurdle.
Is anyone here like against? Because there are some people in this world that are just like that's not something they want to do.
I mean,
like, they won't fire guns.
I mean, if they were never made, that'd probably be a good thing. But they're here.
They're here,
not going
yeah.
anywhere. So.
Yeah.
I'd rather have one than not have one.
That's why all the laws where they're trying to get banned guns, like,
well, yeah, point, it's never going to happen. If you want one, you should get your license now.
Yeah.
Because I've heard, like, years, like a couple years from now, it's just going to be fucking impossible.
Mm-hmm. Well, they're going to make it harder. They'll just never be able to ban them out.
Well,
right?
Yeah. But...
Well, no, because then you'd have, it would spark a whole, like, underground black market.
You make anything illegal. Yeah, there's too many guns out in the wild for them.
Either people would just be too afraid where it's just governments against citizens and we can't do anything to protect ourselves.
Yeah, that's why I think like, no matter, like, for people that are afraid, I completely understand it, but I think it's actually, like, imperative that everyone learns how to handle a gun. Not exactly fire it, but if you're ever in that, like, fucking situation, like
driving school kind of thing.
Yeah, like, I think it's imperative that everyone learns, like, the tools of a firearm. If you're ever in a fucking situation that you need to use it, the last thing you want to not be able to know is how to do it.
Yeah.
Because if it's either you dying or someone fucking killing you, like, I firmly believe in self-defense.
Yeah.
And to have that ability and then you don't know how to use it and then they take your life.
The only problem with that, though, I think is, like, I don't know. Say we taught that stuff in school and, like, you don't really know someone's, like, pretty mentally ill yet because they're still young.
Oh, yeah. No,
but
that...
now you taught them how to use a gun.
Yeah, no, I 100% don't think that. I think it's like when you're older, like 25 or so, that it's good for you to, I mean, learn. I mean, I guess it could have its negative consequences anyway, but for me, I'd rather be safe than sorry.
I don't necessarily think people should be taught how to use something like that.
I just want them to be safe. If the fucking,
it's like, how often our lives are, it's not like a movie. You're not going to come across a situation where you're going to be, a gun slides at your feet and you're going to have to make a decision.
Oh yeah, but...
Soap McTavish, MacTavish.
I'm a safe than sorry person, and I'd rather not be sorry going into a situation I don't know what to do with.
I hear you.
No matter what it is.
I mean, I'm definitely on the fence. In regards to gun ownership, that's a whole different argument. But even on my stance on what I believe gun laws should be and what everything should be, I still think it is important to at least feel what it can do, to at least understand what it can do. So in other words, I
understand,
do,
the consequences.
Yeah, so I do understand. I do believe that even anti-gun people should go to a firing range once. I do believe that at some point they should fire a gun just to truly understand the impact of the weapon. And that might reinforce their views too. Like, yeah, really, this should not exist. Yeah. You know?
It's a tough thing.
I mean, honestly, like, in a way, I'm kind of jealous of the states that, like, you're allowed to just walk around with a holstered gun.
Open carry.
Yes. Open carry.
It's like down in Texas, right? They can do stuff like
that. A lot of states, yeah. Mostly down south. Because, but,
like, I don't know. I'd kind of want to be able to do that.
Well, there, yeah.
I just wouldn't bring it out if I was going out to a bar or something.
Well, yeah, because there is the good stories where someone with an open carry, like, stopped something.
Yeah,
stop the criminal because he had his thing on him or whatever. But it's tough. It's a situation that's never going to be perfected as long as fucking humans are alive on this earth.
But so that'll be the same with anything. Yeah. You know, someone that's going to commit a crime, they're going to do it with a gun or without a gun. Hmm. You know,
even just the fact, like, I know it sounds like movie-like, but, like, even just the fact, like, you're in a, like, convenience store, someone comes in to rob the place, but before they even do that, they see that you're carrying a gun on you.
You stop they it without twice. Knowing, yeah.
Or you become a target. They're like, all right, I got to take this guy down first.
But then does the guy behind the counter have a gun?
We don't know.
I have a gun.
Right, that's now. How all this works. There's
there's consequence. So yeah, like, sure, they may be more unlikely, less likely to do something like that. But if they're still going to go with it anyway, maybe you become a target.
Yeah.
True.
A more obscure case, definitely. No, but, I'm not going to try and use that as a strong counterpoint.
I mean, I didn't think of it like that.
I just
wish they never progressed past the musket.
Freaking musket.
Freaking musket.
Shit, I got to reload. Shit.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing. There really is just too much power to take lives with it. Because it's not like with a musket, if I wanted to go into a place and shoot someone, I'm shooting one person a minute. Like,
yeah, but then you have, now you have people that...
you don't
that,
even know if you're going to hit them.
And if, yeah, exactly. So I can be
or
stopped.
Or kill them.
But now you have people owning ARs in their home.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need that.
Yeah.
You don't need
that's,
a fucking
that's
assault
the other
rifle.
Thing I was thinking about it when you just think of it as a sport. And why shouldn't that person be able to own that?
Yeah, so that's a whole talk time topic we're going to pocket one day where it's... debating that very existence.
I mean, people have their own passions. Why shouldn't people be able to collect them?
Yeah, that's tough.
That's all, like, but I understand at the same time people's arguments, like, why the fuck do you have that?
Well, I think that also specifically answered, should you know?
That I think you should be able to experience it, definitely. I don't know if you should know necessarily all the nuances of it, but I think it's important. It's one of those things that it is such a... It literally is a tool designed to take away life. And whether you're for it or against it, you should understand the consequences of that, what exactly it entails.
I agree.
So,
do each his own.
Do each his own, Michael.
Do whatever you want.
Sure.
Thank you, ladies, gentlemen, boys, girls, hearing, listeners, fearers, viewers, watchers, talkers.
Twatchers.
Oregonians. Shout out to Mike. He's the Arizonian.
Oh, really?
Friend Mike, yes. You commented on one of the videos. Comment what you would do on any of these videos, and please leave suggestions for topics every day besides sometimes Sunday. New video will go live at youtube.com/foreplayvideo, where it's best for you to subscribe to our channel. Check out our website at www.foreplayvids.com, and we're on all social media at foreplayvids. It's just foreplayvideo for YouTube because it wouldn't allow us. So thank you guys for watching and or listening. We'll be back next week with all new topics. Bye.
Sure. Later.
Thank you guys for watching or listening.
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/foreplayvideo.
If you like what we're doing, make sure to smash that like button.
Be sure to share all our videos with your friends so we could continue to grow. And we'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.